referee needs to make no judgment call on that. Again, this match, no disqualification. So they can go off the top rope. They can toss people out over the top. We will definitely have a winner.
Steamboat taking a shortcut back to the ring. Austin thinks he's on this side, but he's on the other side. And Paul Lee is not there to tell Austin. Steamboat on top. Off the top rope. And
he got it.
CW Saturday Night is brought to you in part by Jolly Rancher Candy. Jolly Rancher, the great taste of fruit squared.
Hello again, everybody, and welcome to WCW Saturday Night. Jim Ross and Teddy Long coming to you from the CNN Center in Atlanta. We'll have great wrestling action from center stage on West Peachtree in just a few moments. We'll be showing you what happened this past Wednesday at the Clash of the Champions. We'll focus on the light heavyweight situation. There is no champion now. More on that in the hour. But this is the hour that we're going to see tag team warfare. The Steiner brothers to take on Arn Anderson and beautiful Bobby Eaton, and Michael P.S. Hayes will be in their corner as their strategist. This morning, Teddy Long, on the all-new Power Hour, you said that the smart money was on Anderson and Eaton, and I want to know why.
Well, I'll tell you why. The reason I said that, you've got to take a look at the track record of these three men. You take beautiful Bobby, one half of the Midnight Express. You take Arn Anderson of the Four Horsemen. Then you've got Michael Hayes with the Freebirds. Now, you put all three of these men together, Jim Ross, you have the most dominant team in World Championship Wrestling.
What did you think of that big eight-man tag team event, Sting and Jake Roberts? They got a war going on.
Well, the thing I feel about that is Sting and Jake Roberts may be the match of the year.
Fans, let's go to the ring. We've got six-man tag team action next.
Ladies and gentlemen, introducing first, with a combined weight of 702 pounds, from Seattle, Washington, Greg Valentine. From Tampa, Florida, Dirty Dick Slater. And from Palm Beach, Scotty Flamingo.
We'll kick it off with six-man tag team action here. I want to remind you, we'll be back at center stage here in Atlanta this Tuesday. 7 o'clock, tickets are free for that big TV taping. Back to Rhubarb Jones.
Ladies and gentlemen, making their way. Alexander Bagwell, and from Minneapolis, Minnesota, Z-Man.
And also a special hello for our fans in Gainesville, Georgia. The Georgia Mountain Center, big WCW event there this Wednesday night. That's Wednesday, September the 9th. And Teddy Long, we can expect to see, I think, perhaps four of these athletes in the six-man tag team event that will compete in the upcoming light heavyweight tournament.
Well, when you talk about that light heavyweight tournament, you know the WCW promoters have not finalized that as of yet. But the contenders certainly would be Johnny B. Badge, Scotty Flamingo, Marcus Alexander Baswell, and who knows, the Z-Man.
Scotty Flamingo and Bagwell starting it out here. Collar and elbow tie up from these two light heavyweights. Both these young men got into sport about the same time. Two of the young Lions trying to make a name for themselves here in WCW. And both very competitive. Flamingo likes to take the easy way out. Rather a cocky, arrogant young man, Teddy.
Well, you can see referee Nick Patrick now. He's putting Johnny B. Badge out, but you've got to think back in the past that Scotty Flamingo and Marcus Bagwell, certainly the war is not over with them.
The veteran Greg the Hammer Valentine in. Valentine and Slater, a real tough tag team combination. Arm drag takeover by Bagwell. He's much quicker than Valentine. Valentine forcing Bagwell back into the corner and got a kick right into the knee. We know that Valentine, his hard chops, a master of the figure four leg lock, snapmare takeover. And again, he's taunting Bagwell's partners, Teddy.
Well, you can see Valentine, the seasoned veteran that he is. He's keeping Bagwell right in the middle of the ring and over in the corner with Slater and Flamingo. And now you see Valentine makes the tag with Slater.
Man, what a wild match we saw here Wednesday night. Ron Simmons and Cactus Jack. Cactus Jack really, even though he lost the match, came very, very close in winning the world title. And his stock, quite frankly, rose in my eyes. I thought Cactus Jack gave Ron Simmons all he cared for.
Well, you know, talking about Ron Simmons, we want to mention one other thing, too, that his greatest challenge, in my opinion, is when he meets Ravishing Rick Rude for the world heavyweight title.
Here comes the Z-Man in. And we'll get more on that thought from Theodore Arlong here as action warrants. Z-Man really quickening the pace here, working on the arm of Scotty Flamingo. We saw Z-Man and Flying Brian Pillman in a tremendous light heavyweight title battle at Beach Blast. So Z-Man certainly has the qualifications. Why do you think that Ravishing Rick Rude will be Simmons' toughest competitor, Teddy?
Well, you take Rick Rude. Now, Rick Rude is not a big man, you know. He's not a 400-pounder like Big Van Vader, you know. There's a weight difference there. And Rude, as I've watched him wrestle several times, I can see that he has great stamina. He has great quickness. So Ron Simmons is going to have to try to stay away from Rick Rude. And the thing that Ron Simmons mentioned to me, he said, Teddy, he said, I'm going to have to look out for that Rude awakening. I'm going to have to stay away from it.
Great drop kick by Johnny B. Badd. He is so explosive. We saw those very quick fists hammering at the body of Dirty Dick Slater. Johnny B. Badd, former amateur boxer. Teddy, a young man that you really introduced here in WCW.
Right, and Johnny B. Badd has certainly made a name for himself, and at one time he had to rely on those fists, but now his wrestling skills have improved so till he's been being a tough athlete here in WCW.
Another quick tag. Z-Man brings Bagwell back in. Bagwell sending Slater for the ride, and Slater got that elbow and got it right in the back of Bagwell's head, and he comes with a chop and tags in the pugnacious Greg the Hammer Valentine.
Well, you know, I'm sure Marcus Bagwell remembers Valentine and Slater real well, because at one time they had him in that figure four leg lock. They tried to injure his career.
Valentine just drove his knee right into the lower back of Marcus Alexander Bagwell, and now Scotty Flamingo comes in. A cheap shot on Johnny B. Badd.
Well,
Johnny B. Badd's ready to fight, Ted.
Well, you know what Scotty Flamingo does? I call it strategy. You see, he went right over there, gave Johnny B. Badd a punch. Now, that caused Johnny to come in, so the referee's attention was diverted, and that way he could do some illegal stuff to Marcus Bagwell.
Flamingo choking and drops a knee, but he caught a fist as well. He tried to come off with a knee, and Bagwell got his fist up and up right in the face of Flamingo, and now the tag is made. Tag has been made. Flamingo sails into Slater. Valentine is knocked to one knee, and Z-Man is on fire here.
Well, you see, Jim Ross, now we've got Z-Man with the sleeper hold right on Scotty Flamingo, and all six men are in the ring now.
Johnny B. Badd hammers Valentine. Slater tosses Bagwell out to the floor. Flamingo and Z-Man, I think they're the two legal men, if I'm not mistaken.
Well, the referee's trying to restore some order. He's trying to get Valentine and Slater out of there.
This is a tough job for one official. He's letting it go here. Tip the double team and a drop kick by the Z-Man. But Valentine catches him with the elbow. Johnny B. Badd is battering Flamingo on the far side.
Now Slater has went to the outside. Now Flamingo, whoa, he hits Valentine.
And the left hook just hit Flamingo. The Z-Man's the legal man. He rolls him up and it's over.
The winners of the match, the team of Johnny B. Badd, Marcus Alexander Bagwell, and Z-Man.
Well, Teddy, I know you all have a great program planned for the all-new Power Hour next Saturday morning. I want to thank you for being with us.
Well, thank you so much, Jim Ross. What a pleasure it is to be here. Let me say peace to all the homies.
Welcome back, everyone, to WCW Saturday Night. Jim Ross back with you. Still to come, the Steiner brothers take on Arn Anderson and Beautiful Bobby with Michael Hayes in their corner to determine the number one contenders for the World Tag Team Championship. This past Wednesday at the Clash of the Champions, I had the opportunity to talk to Cactus Jack, who introduced Hacksaw Butch Reed as the Barbarian's new tag team partner. And then they got it on with Barry Windham and Dustin Rhodes. Let's go back to the Clash of Champions and hear these comments and see the Barbarian and Reed in action.
Look at me. I can barely stand. Ron Simmons, I came this close to capturing the championship of the world. But tonight, you were a better man. My head's been hurt. My pancreas punished. I've never felt this bad in my life, but I've never been happier. You see, Simmons, I felt your heartbeat. Quickly, I felt your pulse race. You've got weaknesses, Ron. I couldn't overcome them, but I found a man who could. I called up Danny Spivey. I said, Dan, stay home. I've got a man on our side who knows Ron Simmons better than anyone. He's traveled with him. He's wrestled with him. He's the Barbarian's new tag team partner, and his name is Butch Reed.
Butch Reed. Hacksaw Butch Reed. So Reed's going to be in the tag team matchup.
Oh, you got it. You got it right.
Windham going for the superplex, and he got it. He got it. He floats over. But look at Reed. Windham saw Reed out of the corner of his eye and slams him right off the top. Windham and the Barbarian, the legal man. Dustin Rhodes back in.
All four men in the ring, and as you said, Jim Ross, Windham and the Barbarian illegal. Double drop kicking Hacksaw Reed out to the floor.
Oh, he caught him in the face. He kicked him right in the face. He's put his lights out. Well, there's no doubt that Barry Windham is looking forward to his one-on-one confrontation with the Barbarian, as is Dustin Rhodes with Cactus Jack. But where does Hacksaw Butch Reed fit in this mix? No doubt he knows Ron Simmons, the heavyweight champion, very, very well. And we've heard a lot of talk that the Barbarian wants his opportunity to wrestle Ron Simmons for the heavyweight title. But where does Jake Roberts fit into this situation as well? A lot to think about as far as these four are concerned, but right now let's go back up to the ring. Referee Mike Atkins calls for the bell. Kip Abey to challenge the Barbarian here. Again, thanks for being with us here on WCW Saturday Night. The Barbarian starts off as usual with high impact maneuvers, but this man is certainly not one dimensional. A very quick, a very agile man, and obviously extremely, extremely tenacious. Another thing that you have to admire physically about this individual is his great flexibility. Clothesline to the back of the head. As we saw just moments ago what he did to Barry Windham, extending that big foot right to Windham's face. And that will be an outstanding one-on-one confrontation when they meet. Barbarian just mauling this youngster. He and Hacksaw Butch Reed. What a matchup that would be against Williams and Gordy for the World Tag Title. Great strength. And indeed, Reed knows Ron Simmons probably better than anyone. Barbarian Irish whip, far side, he caught him in the face with that kick. He caught him in the face with it, hooks the leg, and it's over.
The winner of the match, the Barbarian.
Well, fans, I hope you'll call the wrestling hotline. We're on until midnight tonight. I've got some new information on Halloween Havoc. Some new stars are on their way to WCW. And I'll tell you about a high-level meeting that took place last week. We'll be right back. Welcome back, everyone, to WCW Saturday Night. This past Wednesday's Clash of the Champions was a tremendously positive experience for most of us involved. But it wasn't very positive for the Armstrong family. Due to his knee injury, Brad Armstrong could not defend the title, consequently was stripped by WCW officials. This was a real gut-wrenching decision for Executive Vice President of Wrestling Operations, Cowboy Bill Watts. We're going to hear Cowboy Bill Watts' comments. We're going to hear the reaction from Brad Armstrong, and then we're going to see something that transpired that shocked us all.
We've made a rough decision, but the decision is, because it's been over 5 weeks since he's defended the title, we're stripping him of the title, and we will hold a tournament. We'll announce the time and the date and the place for that tournament. And we're really sorry for Brad because he's got the heart. He's part of what makes this tradition great here. Our heart goes out to him, but we do have to honor the decisions of the medical doctors.
I'm extremely let down because of the severity of my injury that I can't possibly defend my title and be 100%. You know, my dad is here. I feel like I've let my family down.
You make me sick, Brad, to sit here and watch a gutless coward like you. I don't know what to say. Frankly, I'm quite embarrassed for you. You're scum. Just to
Brian,
look at
come
you
on, brother.
Makes me want to puke.
Whoa.
I've always been a big fan of Flying Brian Pillman. I admire his competitiveness. I admire his toughness. But I think he took it a step too far there. I think that Flying Brian owes Brad Armstrong an apology. Fans, if you want to see more of the Clash of the Champions, it'll be rebroadcast in its entirety this Wednesday night at 10:05 Eastern Time right here on TBS. And when we come back on WCW Saturday night, we'll take a look at this past Wednesday's volatile 8-man elimination match. That's coming up next. Thanks very much for staying with us, everyone. Jim Ross back with you here on WCW Saturday night. Don't forget to join Michael Hayes and me tomorrow on the main event, 6:05 Eastern Time. More on that in the hour. But this past Wednesday at the Clash of the Champions in the volatile 8-man elimination tag team matchup, one thing is certainly for sure. Sting and Jake the Snake Roberts are far, far from settling their situation. Let's take a look at these highlights from this past Wednesday's 8-man war.
A former heavyweight from Michigan, Irish whipping Big Van Vader at 448 to the corner. But Vader caught him coming in. He kicked him right in the face. But Dogface comes back with the right hand, knocks Vader back to the corner. He missed with that right.
Well, that's the one thing. Whoa, and Vader catches him with a clothesline. The one place I don't feel you should ever attack Steiner is the hand. Because what? There's nothing up there you can hurt.
The Vader bomb right to the corner. The Dogface grinning in trouble. Another clothesline by Big Van Vader, the former world's heavyweight champion, who was unseated on August the 2nd in Baltimore. Steiner's got him up over! A belly-to-belly suplex!
Something's got to give here pretty quick, Jim Ross.
I think it will. Perhaps the vertebrae of the Super Invader. High-impact move by the youngster from Bay City, Michigan. Belly-to-belly, whoa, what a suplex! The former Michigan All-American with a great suplex, but the tag has been made.
Tag
he's
made.
Fell from behind. He went for the Frankensteiner, but he did not see the tag. Koloff that got the tag. Jake Roberts being hammered in the corner. Irish whip far side, Irish whip near side, and the elbow to the face, and the Snake is down. Scoops him up. There's a man from Lithuania. He's hitting anything that moves, including the legal man, Jake the Snake Roberts. Irish whip, left to right, flying shoulder block. Sending the Super Invader for the ride. Oh, he's up with the lights there. What a back body drop. Scoops him up. Sting's tag team partner, Nikita Koloff, has got to go to the showers. It's 4-on-3. Sting really manhandling the masked man. Referee this with Jake. Slingshot suplex. Vader up on top. And Vader, oh, Vader! Vader came down on Rude inadvertently.
He came down on both of them. I think Vader caught both of them. He not only hurt himself, too. We got three guys down in the ring.
Vader's been disqualified for coming off the top rope. He's got to go to the showers. Look at Jake. Jake is pulling Rude, who's virtually unconscious, to the corner, where he can make the tag, quite obviously. Look at Sting.
Look at that. There's the legal tag.
I'm not so sure Sting can even defend himself, Jess.
He's not going to be able to, because right now, if I know Jake, it's DDT time.
2-on-1 here. Jake Roberts and Sting, what a rivalry exists between these two.
Big Van Vader has been disqualified and is eliminated.
DDT! Roberts got Sting with a DDT!
It's over.
placing first with a combined weight of 488 pounds from the state of Minnesota, Double A, Arn Anderson, and from Huntsville, Alabama, Beautiful Bobby. And they are coming to the ring by Michael P.S. Hayes.
And welcome back, everyone, to WCW Saturday Night. Jim Ross back with you. Hope you'll join Michael Hayes and me tomorrow for the main event. I'm sure he's going to have a lot to say about this situation. And we'll also see Wyndham and Rose take on Cactus and the Barbarian.
Ladies and gentlemen, introducing from Detroit, Michigan, with a combined weight of 510 pounds, Rick and Scott Steiner!
This match is to determine the number one contender in the WCW World Tag Team Rankings. Steve Dr. Death Williams and Terry Bam Bam Gordy, the WCW World Tag Team Champions. I know very interested in the outcome of this contest. The Steiner Brothers are currently the number one contenders. So it's a must-win situation for the new combination of Anderson and Eaton that was introduced this past Wednesday at the Clash by Michael Hayes. Hayes brought out a very valid point. Three teams that were dominant in the 80s. The Horsemen, represented by Anderson, the Midnight Express, represented here by Beautiful Bobby Eaton, and the Fabulous Freebirds, represented by Michael Hayes, bring a wealth of tag team knowledge to this contest. Side headlock applied in a good overhand wrist lock counter by Scotty Steiner, and he is so strong, he takes Anderson down there. And Anderson very quickly, before Scotty can really wrench down on the arm, steps into the ropes. Anderson is a tremendous strategist in his own right. But I think that is primarily Hayes' role. Good fireman carry takeover by Scott Steiner. Hope you fans will join me on AM 750 WSB tomorrow night at 9. I hope to talk to Cowboy Bill Watson. We'll be taking your calls beginning at 9 o'clock. We'll also be at the CNN Center tomorrow morning at 10:30 for the Atlanta Falcon tailgate show. Falcons kick off the regular season tomorrow against the Jets. Here Michael Hayes calling out some instructions to Arn Anderson, and Anderson quickly and very intelligently goes to the ropes again. He gets a clean break. And Hayes having somewhat of a philosophical difference with official here. I'll tell you something, the Freebirds, I'm sure, as we once knew them, will never be again. And it's interesting to hear the comments of some of the Freebirds about this situation, namely Buddy Roberts and Terry Gordy. I'll touch on that on the hotline today, and of course Missy Hyatt has a full report on that subject tomorrow on her hotline. Anderson knocked down from that forearm smash by Scotty Steiner. Steiner's involved, as many of you saw in that brutal eight-man elimination tag team matchup we saw highlights of earlier in the program. Anderson, the kick right to the chest. He went for the knee, and Scotty able to move out of the way. Single leg pickup. And Scotty Steiner with a step over leg lock here. I'll tell you something, tag team situation getting as competitive as the single situation. Reed and the Barbarian, as I mentioned, you've got to take that team seriously. Anderson and Eaton here with Hayes, Steiner brothers. Valentine and Slater all shooting for an opportunity to take on the champions. The dog-faced gremlin, the irreverent one. He loves to compete as well as anybody I've ever been around. And he is so, so intense, so tough. But he maintains his composure a little bit better at times than his younger brother. And that has proven to be a problem for the Steiners in the past. Single leg pickup that quickly by the former Michigan heavyweight. Anderson in there a long time in the early going here. Back leg trip. Turns him over to a half Boston Crab. Tag made. Here comes Scotty back in. Again, working on the leg. Good sound strategy employed by the Steiner brothers here. Certainly want to thank you for being with us here on WCW Saturday night. For all of you that watched the broadcast this past Wednesday, over 4 million people watched the Clash of the Champions this past Wednesday, and we thank you for it. Beautiful Bobby gets the tag and wastes no time hammering away at Scotty Steiner with those right hands. Irish whip, but it's reversed, far side. He caught him in a tilt-a-whirl. High impact move by Scotty Steiner. And he's gonna try to turn him over into a submission move, the Boston Crab. Beautiful Bobby fighting, but he can't stop it now. And this is tough. This is a tough one. Right in the middle of the ring. Trying to power his way up. Beautiful Bobby's using a great deal of strength just to hold on here. And Scotty makes the tag with his brother. And Rick not really taking advantage of that Boston Crab. We're going back to work on the leg. Fans, the hottest wrestling magazine in the country is the WCW magazine. The world's heavyweight champion Ron Simmons on the cover. Interesting third degree with Williams and Gordy. And that goes on sale this Tuesday at newsstands nationwide. Look for Ron Simmons on the cover. Another reversal of the Irish whip. Attempted sunset flip, but dogface that low center of gravity. Widens his base and nails him. And nails Anderson with a Steiner line. He nails Eaton with a Steiner line. Oh, what explosion. Fans have got to take a break. We'll keep our cameras taping. If anything happens, we'll show it to you right after you hear this. And welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to WCW Saturday Night. Jim Ross back with you here at Center Stage. This tag team matchup, the Steiner brothers, Beautiful Bobby and Arn Anderson, to determine the number one contenders for the WCW World Tag Team Championship, currently held by Williams and Gordy. Nice athletic move by... So he got the right hand in. He got that right hand in. Beautiful Bobby nails Scott Steiner with a right hand. Half Nelson there by Beautiful Bobby. And Steiner turns into the pressure. He's got the arms around him. We saw this Wednesday night, that display of suplexes. And Beautiful Bobby kicked out at one that time. And there you see the tag with Arn Anderson. Beautiful Bobby, that was a great tag, ladies and gentlemen. He realized he was getting deeper in trouble. Had the opportunity, took advantage of it, and tagged in his partner. Want to say hello to the fans in Dallas, Texas. WCW at the historic Sportatorium in Dallas tonight. In Oklahoma City, Oklahoma tomorrow afternoon at 3 o'clock in the Myriad. And as we said earlier, we're back at Center Stage here on Tuesday. Tickets are free for Tuesday's event, 7 o'clock starting time. Come be with us on the TV taping. And then we'll be up in Gainesville on Wednesday, September the 9th. Great shoulder block by Rick Steiner going to the far side here. And he caught him. He caught him in midair. What a power slam. And Beautiful Bobby in to stop the count with that kick right to the back of the head. But what a move by Rick Steiner. Anderson up. And Beautiful Bobby. He's up on top. And he's going to come off the top right into the arms of big brother Rick Steiner. What tag team effort by the Steiner brothers. The fans voted 88%. to 12% to rescind the off-the-top rope rule. I hope to talk to Cowboy Bill Watts on my radio program tomorrow night. Maybe we will elaborate on that, schedules permitting. Single leg pickup by Scotty Steiner. Well, this kid is, he is a gutsy competitor. And, oh no, right out to the steel. He may have separated his shoulder there, fans. You know, he had surgery on his bicep. Always been a question mark after something that drastic, if it'll ever be the same. But man, he hit the steel there with tremendous force. And Michael Hayes just ran the kid shoulder and upper arm first into the steel. That's an automatic disqualification if the referee sees it. This kid is hurt now. Scotty Steiner is really hurt now, thanks to the efforts of Michael Hayes. The referee, Randy Anderson, exercising his 10 count, and now watch the Sharks feed now. This experienced and highly skilled team of Anderson and Eaton, you can bet, will continue to work relentlessly on the arm and shoulder. And look at Hayes strutting his stuff at ringside. Anderson with that wide base, great placement of the hands, trying to tear the shoulder from its insertion point there, separate the shoulder, quite simply. Boy, this is an intense tag team matchup. And fans, if you get the opportunity, wherever it may be, to see WCW live, don't you miss it. Great cities like Baltimore, Philadelphia, Atlanta, Georgia, where WCW returns on Sunday, September the 20th. Look at Scotty Steiner fight with one arm. This kid has got great guts. The tag was made. Anderson will leave as beautiful Bobby has entered. And they are continuing to work on the arm using any means possible. Scotty is in tremendous pain here. The referee might want to consider keeping a close eye. Oh, the armbar takedown. They're just trying to rip it and tear that shoulder. Referee's got to take a close look at when an athlete can't defend himself. I know this is a high-stakes matchup. It's to determine the number one contender for the World Tag Team title. But you've also got to take a youngster, and that young man right there is concerned about his little brother. You can tell that by the look on his face. The official has got to be deeply concerned about the physical welfare of these athletes. Not to say that this one is not, but Scotty Steiner's shoulder has been hammered into the steel on two occasions. One time by Michael Hayes. And look at this relentless effort by Eaton and now Arn Anderson. As the clash will be rebroadcast in its entirety this Wednesday night, 10:05 Eastern. For those of you that didn't tape, it'll give you a chance to tape those great nostalgia features. Tag made. Shades of the Minnesota Wrecking Crew. Hammerlock into the slam. So tenacious and sadistic. And there is the short arm scissors. Man, their focus point of, you can, if you're a young tag team watching this match, this is textbook. Once they hurt the arm, they went nowhere else. They have worked on that one particular part of the anatomy. Scotty Steiner, I don't know how this kid has held on. This is much like the courage displayed this past Wednesday by the Stinger, being left in there with three guys and three real rivals, Invader, Rude, and Jake the Snake. And Scotty Steiner is showing that same type of intestinal fortitude and desire, because a lesser athlete, I think, would have given it up by now. Hey, good move there. Counter move. Scotty basically trying to wrestle with one arm.
got kicked right in the head by Anderson. Anderson saw that the kid was trying to gain the advantage. And now in for a cheap one. A couple of cheap shots. Kicks right to the chest. Hayes brings a great deal of confidence and, more importantly, knowledge to this team. And that specific knowledge about Terry Gordy has been well, well documented. Good move by Scotty Steiner. And Scotty, what's he going to do here? He's going to pick him up. He's got him up with one arm and slams him. Oh, what a display by Scotty Steiner. Wrestling essentially with one arm. And the tag has been made. And Scotty catches Anderson coming in with a kick. And makes the tag. He made the tag. Rick Steiner in. Hammers away at Anderson. Up in the lights. What a back body drop. And then a right hand. Scotty staying in there. Power slam by Rick Steiner and Arn Anderson. The referee's got to get Scotty out. His brother's a legal man. He got thrown over the top. That should have been a disqualification, but the referee did not see that one. There's Scotty coming out to save his brother from Hayes, and he nails Michael Hayes. That's crap. Hayes getting hammered by Scotty Steiner. Anderson, he's both up on top, but he's the legal man. He's the legal man with the Alabama Jam. The referee did not see it. He's got the Alabama Jam. Anderson's got the leg hook, and they're going to win it.
The winners of the match, the team of Arn Anderson and Beautiful Bobby.
This crowd is shocked. It's an upset, in my opinion. The number one contenders for the World Tag Title. You're looking at them. And this will be our Jolly Rancher Colossal Crunch replay. And there you see the damage done by Hayes on the arm of Scotty Steiner. Both Anderson and Eaton were on the top rope. It's an illegal move. The referee did not see the Alabama Jam. Oh, what a shocking situation here. There you see him hook it up. What a situation here, ladies and gentlemen. New number one contenders for the World Tag Team Championship. And what a matchup it will be with Dr. Steve Williams and your friend, a man that's like a brother to you, Terry Bam Bam Gordy.
You know something, Jim Ross? They say that you're only as good as your word. Well, I guess I'm looking real great about this time, because everything that I gave you and these idiots my word on has come true so far. They are now the number one contenders. And they didn't beat a nobody. They beat the best team in the World Championship Wrestling record books. And they beat them on national TV. Now, we came this close to getting the money too, didn't we, Gordy and Doc? Gordy and Doc. Weren't those such sweet years, Bam Bam? Weren't they great? You think about this. We are coming after those belts. I give you my word, we're gonna take those belts, and I ain't forgot nothing that I taught you. I taught you everything, Terry Gordy, and that idiot Steve Williams, I'm gonna teach him a thing or two, because this is the best combination of the best three tag teams of the 80s, and now we rule the 90s.
Well, fans, I'm sure we'll talk more about this tomorrow in the main event. For everyone here at TBS, including our good friend Rhubarb Jones, I'm Jim Ross saying we'll see you tomorrow at 6:05 right here on TBS.
WCW Saturday Night is brought to you in part by Jolly Rancher Candy. Jolly Rancher, the great taste of fruit squared.